Hi, I'm Ferdinando Almeida. I'm a PhD student at the Stein Monogastric Nutrition Laboratory, and I'm here today to talk about amino acid digestibility in blood products fed to weaning pigs. This is the outline of this presentation. I'll give a background on the blood products that we're going to be using for this experiment and discuss some of the materials and methods, show some results, and a little bit of a discussion and some final conclusions. Because of the high nutritional quality of blood products which are produced from the slaughter industry, these products may be used in diet for pigs. However, the quality of blood products may be affected by the processing that is involved when producing these products. Such processes include spray drying, which yields spray-dried products. We may also have other types of dryers, such as ring, drum, or disc, which may produce the meal product. And it has been shown that there is variation in pig performance when feeding one or another type of blood products. So in this first diagram, I want to explain how the spray-dried blood products are obtained. So starting from the top left, we have whole blood. That whole blood can be spray dried, and then we have spray dried animal blood, or SDAB. We may also take this whole blood and run it through a centrifuge to separate plasma, which is about 55% of whole blood, and also separate into blood cells, which is approximately 45% of whole blood. Now, if we take plasma and spray dry, then we have spray dried plasma protein, or SDPP. And if we take blood cells and spray dry, we have spray dried blood cells, or SDBC. Please get familiar with these abbreviations, as I'll be using them throughout the rest of the presentation. Now, to produce blood meal, we start off with whole blood, which can be obtained from avian species, from porcine, and also from bovine species. And this whole blood goes through an accumulation tank, which is followed by a coagulator, a decanter, and then in the final processes, it goes through a dryer. And as I said in the beginning, this dryer can be a ring dryer, a drum dryer, or a disc dryer, and all these three types of dryers will produce a blood meal at the end. But the problem with the drying process is the Maillard reactions that may occur, and these Maillard reactions, they may decrease the amino acid concentration and also digestibility, but specifically we're concerned about lysine, which is normally the amino acid most affected by heat processing of feed ingredients. The crude protein concentration, however, is relatively constant among feed ingredients that have been heat processed at different degrees of heat. And therefore, we can calculate the lysine to crude protein ratio and use that value to estimate the degree of heat damage in feed ingredients. There is no comparative data on the amino acid digestibility in different blood products fed to weaning pigs, and therefore, the objectives of this experiment were to compare the AID, or apparent ileodigestibility, and the SID, or standardized ileodigestibility of crude protein and amino acid in spray-dried animal blood, spray-dried blood cell, spray-dried plasma protein, and two sources of blood meal, one from avian species, so avian blood meal, and another one from porcine species, so porcine blood meal. Now for the materials and methods. We used 7 wheeling barrels with an initial body weight of 11.5 kilograms. They were surgically equipped with a thick cannula in the distal ileum, and they were allotted to a 7x7 Latin square design with 7 diets and 7 periods. This table shows the diet composition, And here in the first column, we have the diet containing spray-dried animal blood. That diet contained 9% of casein and 9% of spray-dried animal blood. And we also included some cornstarch, about 34%, lactose at 20%, sugar 15%, and others making up for 13% of the diet. All diets containing the blood products, they contain 9% of the blood product that was used and also 9% of casein. So we calculated the SID of amino acids and crude protein by the difference procedure. The last diet on the right was a casein diet, which contained 18% of casein. We also formulated a nitrogen-free diet, which was used to determine the basal endogenous losses of crude protein and amino acids. Pigs were fed 3 times the daily maintenance energy requirement, and as I said before, we calculated AID and SID by the difference procedure as outlined by Fenn and Sauer in 1995. Data were analyzed using the mixed procedure of SAS. The model included diet as the fixed effect, peak and period as random effects, and we used LS means to calculate means and the PDF option to separate the means with an alpha level of 0.05. Now let's move on to the results. In this first graph, we have the standardized ileodigestibility of crude protein. So on the y-axis, we have digestibility in percent. And on the x-axis, we have the first 3 bars in orange representing the spray-dried products. And the 2 columns on the right represent the 2 sources of blood meal, avian blood meal or porcine blood meal. And what we observed here is that the SID of crude protein was not different among the 3 sources of spray-dried blood products. However, the SID of crude protein in the spray-dried blood products was greater than the SID of crude protein in the 2 sources of blood meal, which were not different among themselves. For the SID of lysine, we observed again that there were no differences among spray-dried blood products. However, the SID of lysine in spray-dried blood products was greater than the SID of lysine in blood meal. Now for the threonine, we observed a similar pattern as for SID of crude protein and also as for SID of lysine. And again, for tryptophan, we also observed that there were no differences among the spray-dried blood products, but the SID of tryptophan in these products was greater than the SID of tryptophan in the 2 sources of blood meal. Now moving on to the discussion. First, the SID values for spray-dried plasma protein agree with previous data. And we did observe that the SID values for spray-dried animal blood were slightly above 100%, and this has been observed previously for blood products as well. And some of these may be explained by the variability in endogenous amino acid losses among diets. We also observed that the digestibility of amino acids and crude protein was greater for the spray-dried products versus the blood meal products, and this may be explained by the drying processes, which may cause some heat damage. In this process, Maillard reactions occur, and the Maillard reactions are the condensation of reducing sugars and amino acids or protein, and as I said, lysine is the most affected, and because of these reactions, lysine becomes unavailable to pigs. There are also some protein cross-linkages that are formed during these Maillard reactions, and these cross-links may reduce the digestibility of other amino acids. Therefore, From this, we believe that spray drying is a more gentle processing of drying feed ingredients, as it may cause less heat damage. And this is supported by the lysine to crude protein values that we calculated for the spray dried products, which was 9.3 versus 8.6 for blood meal. So this indicates that blood meal is indeed more heat damaged than spray dried products. And this may be the reason why we observed less digestible amino acid for blood meal compared with spray dried products. So we conclude from this experiment that blood products are excellent sources of crude protein and amino acid. Spray-dried products have SID of crude protein and amino acid that is close to 100%, and blood meal is less digestible than spray-dried products. And we also observed that there are no differences among animal sources. So if you have an avian blood meal or a porcine blood meal, we should not see any differences in the digestibility of crude protein and amino acids. I would like to acknowledge Evonik Industries for funding this project. And I thank you all for listening to today's presentation.